Class, today we're going to take a look at a method of solving systems that's called the addition method in some places. And another name you often get is the elimination method. So if you see something that says solve by the addition method or solve by elimination, this is going to be the method that you want to use. Now, it's called the addition method because one thing that you do when you're solving is you add the equations together. It's called the elimination method because when you add those equations together, your goal is to make one of the variables eliminate. So let's take a look at the steps and apply this particular method to the system that we have here. The first step is to multiply one or both of the equations, if it's necessary, it isn't always necessary, by numbers that make it so a variable will eliminate. And if you take a look at these two equations, if I was to just draw a line underneath here and do old-fashioned addition and add straight down, that the way these are right now, these x's would not eliminate. I'd end up with 5x. And the y's would not eliminate either. I'd end up with 4y. Our goal is to make it so one of those variables eliminates. So we can either choose to eliminate our x's or eliminate our y's. You just have to kind of choose one, and then what you do is you look at the numbers in front of the variables and you make it so that they are the same value with opposite signs. Now, if we were choosing x's to eliminate, we'd want 1 to be a positive 6 and 1 to be a negative 6, because that's the smallest thing 3 and 2 go into. If we choose the y's, which is what I'm going to choose, I notice that 1 is already negative and 1 is already positive. So all I need to worry about is the numbers, and 1's a 5 and 1's a 1. If I multiply this equation by 5, this would be a negative 5y, which when added to this second equation will eliminate with this positive 5y. So that's going to be my strategy for this first step. I'm going to multiply this first equation by 5, multiplying it by the 3x. My new equation I'm going to write over here is 15x minus 5y equals 55. Now we'll just carry over the second equation. We didn't do anything with it, so it's just going to stay 2x plus 5y equals 13. Now I can draw a line underneath them, and if I add straight down, notice my y's will eliminate. That was our goal, to make one of the variables eliminate. When you're adding straight down, another thing that happens is your equal sign will carry straight down, just like a decimal would if you were adding decimals. So now if I add my numbers here, 55 and 13 ends up being 68, and then adding straight down over here, 15x and 2x is 17x. What we are left with right here is a very easy equation for us to solve. All you have to do is divide both sides by 17, and in doing so, oops, I need to get out of color. I'll divide both sides by 17, and x ends up being 4, because 4 times 17 ends up being 68. So now notice that what we've already done in just this little bit of work we've done here is step one of multiplying one or both of the equations by a value. Then we added the two equations together, which was step two, and we've already solved for the remaining variable. We got x to be 4. So step four is we need to substitute this answer here into either of the original two equations. It doesn't matter which one, you just need to pick one and plug it in. I'm going to go ahead and plug into the bottom equation, and then we'll solve for our y. So in doing that, I end up with 2 times the 4 we just got for x plus 5y equals 13. Simplifying, we get 8 plus 5y equals 13. We now need to move our 8 over, so I'm going to subtract 8 from both sides. And we end up with 5y equals 5. And finally, divide both sides by 5, and y is 1. So now our final thing we need to do is to write our answer as an ordered pair. So the solution is 4, 1. And that's how you go about solving by using the addition method. Now let's try another example. I'm going to eliminate this one, but leave our steps up that we have here. Our next example is going to be a little bit different. Now, one thing that I didn't mention in that last example was that both equations should be in standard form for this method to work nicely. In the last example we did, both of them were in standard form. But notice that in this particular example we have right here, we don't have either equation in standard form. This one has the x on one side and the y on the other, and this one has the y over here and the x over here. Standard form, if you'll remember, is ax plus by equals c. We need both equations in that form in order to do this process. So on this first equation, to get standard form, I need to subtract y from both sides. And that makes this first equation 9x minus y equals 25. For the second equation, I need to add 9x to both sides in order to get it in standard form. And that gives me 9x plus 2y equals 4. Notice that now these are in standard form. And I notice that for multiplying my equations by a value in order to make it so that I can eliminate a variable, that these x's both have 9's. So if I just make one of them negative and one of them positive, they'll eliminate. That just means I need to multiply one equation by negative 1. And that's going to make it so that all of the values in this equation that I chose will change their signs. We'll get negative x plus y equals negative 25. The other equation we'll leave alone. And then we'll go ahead and draw a line, carry our equals sign down, and add straight down. Notice our x's eliminate. Y and 2y is 3y. Negative 25 and 4 is negative 21. Now we just need to divide both sides by 3, and you'll notice that y is negative 7. Now, we've got a variable. We're not done yet. Notice all we've done is added the two equations together after multiplying by negative 1, which sometimes you don't have to multiply by a number, but in these examples we have. We solve for the remaining variable. Now we have to do step 4 and substitute that answer back in order to find the other variable. I'm going to go ahead and take and substitute this negative 7 that we found out y was into this first equation right here. That gives me 9x minus negative 7 equals 25. The double negative here makes positive, and then if I want to move that 7 over, I'll subtract 7 from both sides. So I get 9x equals 25 minus 7 is 18. And now if you divide both sides by 9, x is 2. So our solution here is going to be, and again writing it as a sentence, the solution is the ordered pair 2, negative 7. Now, let's look at one more system that we're going to do by the addition method, but at first glance, it's going to be a little bit scary. I'm going to give you a way to deal with it that's going to make it so it's not as bad. This particular one is going to be a little bit scary because of the fact that it's going to have a bunch of fractions in it. But we need to remember something back from the last class. When you just solve regular equations, if you want to get rid of a fraction, you just multiply by the least common denominator. We're going to do that in order to make these problems easier. The system we're going to deal with is x over 3 minus y over 2 equals 2 over 3. And then the other equation is 2x over 3 plus y equals 4 over 3. What we need to do for this particular system is first just get rid of our fractions and then start all over. Doing that's going to make it much easier for us. So if we just first look at this first equation here, the denominators are 3 and 2. And so 6 would be the common denominator. If we multiply this whole equation by 6, our denominators are going to disappear. Let's write our new equations that we're going to start over with over here. So 6 times x over 3, the 3 goes into 6 twice, and we get 2x. And then 6 times negative y over 2, the 2 goes into the 6 3 times, and we get negative 3y. And then 6 times 2 thirds, the 3 goes into the 6 twice, and 2 times 2 gives you 4. So that's our new equation there. Now, if we take a look at our second equation, the denominators are 3. So our least common denominator is just going to be 3 for us. So let's multiply everything by 3. And that will eliminate the fractions on this equation. 3 times 2x over 3, the 3's cancel, and we just end up with a 2x. 3 times y is just a 3y. And 3 times 4 thirds, the 3's cancel, and we end up with a 4. Now, I notice something really nice. I don't have to do anything with this new system. I can just add them because we got lucky and these y's are going to already cancel for us. So all we need to do now is draw a line, carry our equals down, and the y's cancel. We're left with 4x equals 8. Solving this, we divide both sides by 4, and x ends up being 2. Now, we want to take that 2 and substitute it back in to one of the equations in order to find our y. We want to pick something that's going to be fairly easy to get our y value. And we can choose any of these four equations. If you choose not to deal with the fractions, you can choose one of these. If you don't mind choosing one with a fraction, this one here would be nice for solving for y because our y doesn't have a variable or a number in front of it. I'm going to substitute into this one. So I'm going to end up with 2 times the 2 we just got x for x over 3 plus y equals 4 thirds. 2 times 2 gives me 4 thirds plus y equals 4 thirds. And then let's just subtract 4 thirds from both sides to move this over. These cancel, and over here we end up with 0, so y is 0. So we have 0 for y and 2 for x, so we would say that the solution is the point 2, 0. And now you're ready to go tackle your problems that deal with the addition method.